Hello everyone, my name is John Benisundra and today I'm gonna teach you how to paint this wonderful forest painting. So today everyone, my subject will be a swampy forest, or there will be a swamps on the forest. Okay, and please don't forget to subscribe. You have to subscribe it and hit the bell button if you want to receive some future notifications on my new videos and tutorials. Okay, you can see all the materials needed in the screen. Consider 5 limited colors and brushes that we're gonna need, and all the things that we're gonna need to paint this painting. Okay, so I'm going to start now, and I have a blank canvas here, and I will start with the underpainting. Okay, so I'm going to use this 1.5 inch flat brush. Okay, I have here the yellow and then red to mix some orange and white. So I put yellowish center of the forest. I will paint the underpainting first, everyone, and then I will also put some bluish with white. I have to blend the colors, everyone. That's actually the first step, blending. There, I'm gonna put a bit of greenish. Yellow and a bit of blue. Okay, there, and I'm going to add a bit more reddish brown, everyone. I like to create some reddish brown there. I don't want to make so much greenish color. There. I will try to add a bit of orange also. Like there are reddish and orange leaves there. There. There, so yeah, so we have blended it good, everyone. I can add more orange. I like to have more orange, everyone, in my background. We just have to blend it good. Okay, there you go. So we have now the other painting. So yeah, it's on the soft, and this will be my center, everyone. This part, I want this to be very bright like that. I want to start creating some trees on the far, something like that. The tree is there, that's on the distance. Okay, so this will be like maybe a clearing going to the outside, and this will be a swampy forest. Okay, so everything will be water here, a little bit more some grasses, you can say some grasses, but mostly water. Okay, so I'm going to use smaller brush. Yeah, maybe I'm gonna use this brush, everyone. It's the smallest nano brush I have. Then let's use this color here, just existing colors of browns. There. So I just assume that these are some trees also, but I want it to be very faded or misty, something like that. I'll try to create one big tree here, but it should be misty, everyone. Okay, so I need some yellow. I have here the raw umber. I'm gonna mix it with the blue color. So I will try to put one tree here. Yeah, this one will be a bit of doesn't have to be perfect. There, so something like that. Also here, everyone. So here. Yeah, so we have now those few details for our forest. I will put one big tree here, everyone. A big tree with a lot of leaves also here. No, I mean with so here maybe I'll put something like that. So I am just sketching up, everyone. We're going to put those elements, those trees there. Okay, then on the near party run, I want it to be darker. I just use the raw umber and the blue. object. And even the other side, put it here. I will use a bigger brush now. This medium size flat brush. The same color, everyone. Remember with the blue. Okay. We can add more. Bronze, everyone. There. Later on, we can add much finer details there. Okay, there you go. And then I'm gonna try to add a bit of lighter color. This is a scary forest, everyone. We do not know what's in there. I have to put a bit of leaves, everyone, like that. So just stopping technique to create a bit of leaves. I have to continue also the leaves here. And I'm going to put maybe here around the light rays. Okay, I don't know, I just want to put like that. I'm going to add a bit of bluish and yellow and red. Let's create some reflection. There. And here I can put a bit of darks. The paint's still wet, everyone. I have to do it slowly. Sorry, it's wet. Okay, I'll use now a bit of smaller brush. I'm gonna use this umber, a bit of darks. I'm gonna add now slowly everyone some brushes. Okay. So I will try to put the light coming from here, everyone. Yeah, light that is striking through here, this part. It will be great. I think it will be good because it will create more lights, very good lights that it will make it more like a misty forest. There. Yeah. Okay, that's looking like a forest now, everyone. I like how simple it is. There's a lot of things there, but it looks so scary. The forest looks so scary, everyone. But I like it. I love how it looks. Yeah. Okay, so I need to continue. So I have to put a bit of trees also. No, I mean leaves there. So I'm gonna use my bristle flat brush. And then where's my bristle flat brush now? It's here. I have to put some greenish everyone, dark greenish or even, yeah. I want to make this part also a bit of greenish. Yellow and the blue and then red. I'll just make it more like an abstract, everyone. Okay. I will also put a little bit of orange. Okay, and I need to also put some darks there, everyone. Dark leaves. But I think I'm gonna do this one first. I'm gonna put some, yeah, maybe this one first. Thank you. Okay, and then I will try some greenish. Can also try something like this. Most everyone. There. Okay, there you go. And in this one, I'm gonna make it a little bit darker. This tree here. Okay. Have the wrong everyone. I'm gonna make this part a little bit darker. This one. This tree. And then I'm gonna put a light here, a striking light, everyone. So I have to use some white and then a little bit yellow. So I want it to be like a morning or afternoon. Okay. Make it, do not wet it, everyone. Make sure that's dry. Just drag it down like that. Maybe a little bit bluish. There, so as you can see, there's a wave. Oh no, there's a sunlight here. Let's make it brighter. Thank you.
Okay, that's good. As you can see now, the a bit of difference there. It make it look so good. Okay, so this forest around would be just very simple to paint, but a little bit complicated in details. I'm going to use this swamper. Kind of darken this part. Some parts still wet. I have the blue, the yellow, and the red. More yellow. Almost everyone like that. There, okay. I have the umber. Let's darken this part. You can also put a bit of greenish. There. Okay. So more like a greenish color one. Put it here. If you're painting, just follow what I'm doing and always have fun. Don't forget. There. As you can see now, the tree looks so good. Okay, as you can see now, everyone, it's becoming much harmonious now. So let's continue adding much more detail. I'm going to add some more darker leaves on the trees. So I'm going to put darker greenish leaves, everyone, but it should be darker blue and amber. And then I have here the yellow and then red. Yellow. And then red. There. Okay. Here also can pour we can put some darker greener leaves. There, so everything becomes clear now. Yeah. It looks creepy, everyone. But it looks good. Even you can put amber, right? Okay, yeah, and then I'm gonna darken this branch around this big branch here, because that's supposed to be dark. Blue amber, I have the blue and the red. Okay, I can put a little branch there. So you can see now, everyone, everything's on the layer by layer. Okay, and then also here. And then this one, everyone, I'm gonna make it also detailed. Thank you. And then this one I'm gonna try to add yeah, maybe some grasses there. Okay, so I'm going to add now a little bit of some light here, everyone. Okay, so we can add it a little bit orange and then white. We can also put greenish because I don't want that the tree, my tree is always are always brown. I want to put greenish also. So I'm gonna put a bit of greenish, everyone. Greenish light, I think. I like to put showcase some highlights here. There. Also here. There. At least you can see now the greenish tones on the body. Okay, so it looks like it's inside the forest. Yeah, and the forest looks a bit creepy, everyone. But it looks good. It's good. Okay, so I'm gonna put also a bit of darks here. In the reflection, don't forget. There. There, so at least you can see the reflection there, which is so good. The water reflection, everyone. Yeah. And also here. This one also. Yeah. So as you can see now, it looks like a water. We can put some greenish also, or maybe to orange or browns in the water, everyone. Like the theme, everyone. It's a bit scary, but I like the look. I like how it is portrayed. Okay. Yeah, it's a bit scary. The painting's a bit scary. I'm going to add a bit of darks here on this part. We're using this dark color here. Maybe some umber. So I like the look that it's dark there on the other side. Maybe I can put some brownish there, like falling leaves, something like that. Raw umber and red and yellow. Thank you.
Put some lights there, okay? So here. So it's hit by the light. Okay, there you go. So everything looks very simple, everyone. The reflection looks very simple. It's even not even 1 hour and we are almost done. Yeah, we're almost on the final stage. I'll just try to add more details and I think I will be finished. Okay. I'll try to add maybe a bird. Yeah, it will be a good addition, everyone. I'm not sure if it's needed. But yeah, I think we can. Okay. Yeah, we can add some birds. It will make the whole painting different, alive. Okay. I'll just try to add some a bit of details like this. I'm gonna put this a bit of light bluish green here. Can see that there's still a bit of a bluish color or greenish thing on the body or the trunk. Here. Yeah, I want this part of one to be off, like it doesn't hit by the light. There's a bit of few lights there, but doesn't hit so much. There, so that part's off. Okay, yeah, this painting, everyone, is so simple and chaotic. I'll just try to add some birds and I think we'll be finished. I'll be using a small brush. White. I'm gonna use a bit of gray stone here. Yeah. maybe here.
There. It's like a, it's a silhouette.
And then here. Okay, that's another bird there. I think I'll put one here. Okay, I'm gonna try to add a bit of highlights. It's catching something, maybe a fish. There. Okay. So, yeah, I think this will be enough for today. Okay everyone, so I think this is enough for today, and I think yeah, for the beginners this will be a good practice, everyone. So yeah, I urge you to try this one. This will be, you can learn the blending of a light or blending of values of colors, and you can also practice here how to create this kind of environment, everyone, which is
forest, and you can see there on the little bit distance, a little bit misty colors to create atmosphere on the painting. So yeah, you can see here a little bit misty on the background, and then there's a light there, and you can see on the foreground the dark part of the forest, which is the near part, which does not hit by the light. Okay, so it's a good practice for you, and you can try this one. I hope that you can learn from this one, and actually this is a good practice for you. So just try it and always have fun.
Okay everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.